The king. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yo-yos and harmonicas, you know they can't be beat. You better make that run to the cornerstone. Treat yourself to a treat. I'm going downtown. Gotta find myself some fun. I'm going downtown. Won't eat in it.
Refried Mountain Sprite, refried Best of the Beans. We're gonna get ready to do a great big CD release party, scavenger hunt, blah blah blah, up here at the Harvest Fest here this weekend.
You got a scavenger hunt going?
Oh yeah, apparently. Yeah, don't be passing it all out. You'll find out what you got to go find. It's all in the effort of keeping it Arkansas.
Gotcha. So, in the effort of keeping it authentic, you guys, you're playing acoustically, you're capable of plugging in, but...
Well, we just get tired of carrying the heavy equipment, to tell you the truth. It's, you know, we've just, over the, you know, we used to have the huge things, and all that stuff, just a lot more to carry. It's like wasted energy, so now we've pared it down, what? And, you know, if we do actually lose our van, we can always walk home.
The thing about going a cappella is so we don't have to carry anything.
Sweet.
That's right. It'd be like a Tabernacle Boys Club.
It's always cool to play these festivals where there's a bunch of jam bands playing, because I definitely grew up on jam bands. I grew up on The Dead, and I grew up on Phish. The Grateful Dead were like the, probably listening to the Grateful Dead Skull and Roses record on a Maxell 90-minute tape that my dad had dubbed over from vinyl, was probably like the musical moment in my life. I was like 12 years old, and I was like, oh my God, there's something greater in the universe than any, you know, than the people around us, and it was like black magic, introduction to black magic. But I also grew up on The Band and, you know, a little Cat Stevens, quite a bit of Bob Dylan, like a lot of kids, you know, had my mind blown by Bob Dylan. I was like 15 years old, which actually discouraged me from having any interest in writing songs, because I was like, well, he's kind of done it. I really don't have anything to add. It took a while, you know. I had to get beat up a little bit by life before I found myself inspired enough to, you know, feel like I had something to contribute. Finding a career in music came out of just having fun with it. You know, it was what I wanted to do, what I wanted to spend my time with, and out of spending time playing music and spending time interacting with other musicians, a sound began to emerge, and you know, I found myself more often on stage and in studios, and you know, it all kind of happened working.
Speaking of that, do you have any, you know, you're at a festival. I understand you might be having a guest on your set here in a little bit.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. I met a girl named Jenny from, was it Dead Winter?
Carpenters.
Carpenters, mm-hmm. Yeah, Dead Winter Carpenters. She seemed nice. I've never heard her play before, but I was watching this band, Oakhurst, absolutely mm-hmm. crush it on stage, so I figured it was a little bit intimidating, me going up after them, solo acoustic. So I said, hey, so what do you play? And she said, fiddle. And I said, you play a couple songs? And she said, oh, cool.
Let me welcome everybody to the wild, wild west. A state that's untouchable like Elliot Ness. The track hits your eardrum like a slug to your chest. Pack a vest for your Jimmy in the city of sex. We the sunshine state with the bomb ass hempy. State where you never find a dance floor empty. And hence me, on a mission for them greens. Lean, mean, money making machines serving fiends. I've been in this game for 10 years making rap tunes. Ever since Honeys was wearing Sassoons. Now it's 95 and they clock me. Watch me diamond shining. I rob Liberace, but it's all good from Tahoe to the Bay. Your city is the bomb if your city making pain. Throw up a finger if you.